Hi there. Today we're going to be speaking about the mirror on the Mercedes Class S W126. That's the mirror I used to. I've got on my vehicle, and as you can see, it has a problem. So what I've done, I bought another one, thinking it would be just a straight swap. Fortunately, I've been wrong. I've noticed later when I received it that in fact there's two different type of plugs. If you can see here, it's kind of rectangular, and on this one it's more square. So what we'll try and do in this video, we're gonna try and dismantle everything. So like that, if you need later to know how to change the mirror, etc., you will know how to do it. Okay, and once it's dismantled, we'll try to swap the plugs around so we can fit this one later on the vehicle. So first, we will have to remove the rubber. Now, if you look at here, if it's never been dismantled before, you will see that here there's a clip. Okay, a plastic clip that I've got on the other one that I'll show you. It's here. So to remove that, because if you try and pull it out without removing this, you will break it. So to remove that, you will see it's just fitted inside. So by under, it's difficult to show you. If you have a look by under, I can't show you unfortunately, but if you take a screwdriver, a very thin screwdriver, you push it, this will come out and you'll be able to recover it without damaging it, and then the cover will come off. What we need to do now is push the mirror that way, so here it will open at the maximum. And when we look at the back here, so it's very difficult to see, but here there's a little wire, a little clip. Let's see. See, it's round. It's round. We can hardly see it, but it's here. If you grab it with a small screwdriver like the one I've got here, you pull it towards you and up, and normally the mirror will come off. Well, now we have the mirror open, so I'll show you how to what we've done. What we've done is we remove this this small cable. You can see that brown part. So it used to be all around and fitted here. It needs to go well everywhere. So it was like this. So this is what I've showed you before on the video, and what you have to do is pull this towards you and up. Okay, so once it comes off, then you can remove it. Well, as you can see, I've opened the other one too, and if you can see here, this mirror is actually attached by a cable, which I suppose is for heating it. The motor as well is a bit different. Well, we have now the two mirrors dismantled. This one is with the heating system, and this one is the normal one. Just in case you need to buy the parts, here it is. The normal one is 126 810821, and this one with the heating system is 126 811 0822. In any case, I will put it on the video, so like that you will have the reference in case you need to buy it. For the rest, if I compare the boxes, I can see that the motor is different, but the rest seems to be exactly the same. The mounting, etc., the spring. So I'm just gonna remove those two screws on each side. Normally, that will remove the back, and I should be able to swap them over. Okay, I've just removed the two screws that way on each side, and normally now if we pull here, the cap should come off. Okay, here we go. Perfect. So now we just need to remove the motor. Okay, everything is now dismantled, and I was hoping that I could swap this for this one, in order to recover the plug. Unfortunately, I won't be able to do it, because if you look at the back here, there's four holes where four screws are, and on this side is one here and two there. So the fitting of the motor is actually different. So big shame. We can clearly see here the four and one and two here. So the only thing I've got left to do is to fit it back all together, unfortunately, because that won't be of any use to me. But we have now learned how to dismantle the mirror in case you need to change the motor or the cap, for instance. Talking about the caps, you should know that there's also two different types. As you can see, they're exactly the same, except that this one, metal, and this one, plastic. So obviously I would prefer a metal one. Okay. To fit it back all together, it's exactly the same thing as we did, but reverse. Regarding the mirror, alors, you may think, how are we going to do about that that spring? Because once it's like that, to bring it back is going to be a bit difficult. So in fact, what you do, you just fit it normally, and you will push it on the, like that on the on its frame, and you'll push it. You clip it, and normally, if you press it well, it'll get clipped. There we go. So that's how you have to do it. Okay. Well, I hope this would have taught you something, and we'll see you on the next video.
Well, my friends, I hope you enjoyed the video that I've shown you and you enjoyed it. Please subscribe to the channel and give me a like. And if you feel like it, you can leave me a comment as well. Well, see you on the next video.